The great conflict of the ages is about to intensify. But remember the words of Jesus: "In me you might have peace. In the world you shall have tribulation, but be of good cheer. I have overcome the world." Would you like to know how to exercise courage and fight the good fight of faith? Listen to this devotional.
Conflict and Courage, a Daily Devotional by Ellen G. White. Confrontation at Jacob's Well. "Whosoever drinketh of the water that I shall give him shall never thirst, but the water that I shall give him shall be in him a well of water springing up into everlasting life." John 4, verses 14. When Jesus sat down to rest at Jacob's Well, he had come from Judea, where his ministry had produced little fruit. He was faint and weary, yet he did not neglect the opportunity of speaking to one woman, though she was a stranger, an alien from Israel, and living in open sin. As the woman talked with Jesus, she was impressed with his words. She realized her soul thirst, which the waters of the well of Shechar could never satisfy. Nothing that had hitherto come in contact with her had so awakened her to a higher need. Jesus had convinced her that he read the secrets of her life. Yet she felt that he was a friend, pitying and loving her. While the very purity of his presence condemned her sin, he had spoken no word of denunciation, but had told her of his grace that could renew the soul. Leaving her water pot, she returned to the city to carry the message to others. With heart overflowing with gladness, she hastened on her way to impart to others the precious light she had received. "Come, see a man which told me all things that I ever did," she said to the men of the city. "Is not this the Christ?" Her words touched their hearts. There was a new expression on her face, a change in her whole appearance. They were interested to see Jesus. As soon as she had found the Savior, the Samaritan woman brought others to him. She proved herself a more effective missionary than his own disciples. Their thoughts were fixed upon a great work to be done in the future. They did not see that right around them was a harvest to be gathered. But through the woman whom they despised, a whole cityful were brought to hear the Savior. This woman represents the working of a practical faith in Christ. Every true disciple is born into the kingdom of God as a missionary. He who drinks of the living water becomes a fountain of life. The receiver becomes a giver.
My faithful Father, enduring friend, your tender mercies like a river with no end, it overwhelms me, covers my sin each time I come into stand in wonder once again. Your grace still amazes me. Your love is still a mystery. Each day I fall on my knees, 'cause your grace still amazes me.
Your grace still amazes me. Oh, patient Savior, you soul. What can I give you? Lord, what can I say? I know there's no way to repay you, only to offer you my praise. Your grace stirs.